Font pairing is something that designers often do struggle with, but it's something so, so important to graphic design. If it's a logo design, a website design, a poster, brochure, whatever it is, a good font pair is going to help your work succeed. And today's video, I'm offering you some of the best tried and tested font pairs that you can use totally for free on your next project. Sponsoring today's video is a long-term friend of Satori Graphics, and that is Milanote. To learn about new features and how to streamline your graphic design workflow with Supreme Organization, stay tuned to the very end of today's video. So the first font pair uses two of my favorite sans serif typefaces of 2021, and that is Basement Grotesque and Elrond. Now these font families are so versatile and so easy to use, and when combined in the right way, they can really work well together. Because they are both sans serifs, I like to utilize contrast either in size or thickness. Now I tend to use Basement Grotesque for large headings or phrases, and then complement this with smaller size Elrond, often at a weight of semi-bold or bold. And you could of course flip it around so Grotesque is on the bottom and Elrond is the main heading, but I prefer to use Basement Grotesque as the main typography. And next up, a pairing of serif typeface with a sans serif typeface. Everybody should know Helvetica New, and that's combined with EB Garamond. Both are very neutral and classic to their specific font categories, and when paired up together, while considering hierarchy, they do work well. For instance, maybe a fashion magazine or for fashion brand marketing artwork, EB Garamond could represent the heading and main typography, and then you could have paragraphs of Helvetica to complement it in a subtle way. And the third pair today is an unlikely pair, and that being Neutra and Kaufmann. Neutra is a very straight-edged, angular sans serif typeface, whereas Kaufmann is a free-flowing and personal-displayed handwritten style font. In the right situation, these typefaces can be used to contrast each other. Just like always, be aware of the brief and also the target market. Ask yourself if these fonts will play into the message that you want to deliver. Font pair number 4 is another sans serif typeface close to my heart, and that's Bebas, but mixed up with Montserrat. Now Bebas is great for bold titles and attention-grabbing main sources of typography on your designs. Montserrat can come along and apply a sophisticated contrast, especially at the thinner weights. Montserrat also pairs up with Oswald as well, which is quite similar in style to Bebas. But yeah, this is a pair that is fun to experiment with on posters or even things like website designs. And the fifth font pair in today's video is a font pair that both come from Google Fonts. That's Libre Franklin and Libre Baskerville. Just because they have the same word in their name doesn't mean they look similar. Actually, it's quite far from that. It's a cliche pairing of a serif and a sans serif typeface, but in this instance, I would say that Libre Baskerville, the serif typeface, would be best suited for the headings. You can then complement that with the sans serif typeface Libre Franklin. Libre Franklin is actually optimized for on-screen readability, and so it would work well for body text and smaller areas of your designs. The sixth font pair is another serif and sans serif combination, and here we have Oswald and Quattrocento. I would personally use Oswald in the same way that I use Bebas, that being for headlines, titles, and main areas of large typography. Quattrocento is so elegant and pristine, it can really complement Oswald here as a body text in small areas of typography on your design. And as you can probably tell from today's video, pairing fonts is all about contrast of style, size, weight, and a careful eye for design. So yeah, sponsoring today's video is Milanote, a tool that I've been using literally for years at this point. Milanote is great for creating mood boards, task lists, client profiles and briefs, and just generating those killer ideas for your client projects. You can collaborate with different designers or people on your team all on one project board. And now, instead of typing out labels, you can choose to annotate with this markup feature, which is quick and easy to use. When generating ideas, we need inspiration and relevant media to generate good concepts. The new card feature now offers a wider scope for things that you can bring onto your boards. And I personally find it really helpful to be able to drop specific colors onto my boards with this card drop feature. You can organize your projects with Milanote totally for free and with no time limit attached. Simply click the link in the description box below and head over to Milanote and find out how your work can truly excel with a little bit of organization. But if you want to see more videos about fonts, typography, and graphic design, do click the video on screen. And until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.